Greetings, friends. Charles Fellingham here, welcoming you to this episode of What Hollywood Teaches Us About. This video series takes excerpts from popular movies that support sound advice and winning strategies for important business topics. Our topic today is quality and process control. And the film segments are from The Founder, which is a 2016 American biographical drama film directed by John Lee Hancock and written by Robert Siegel. The film stars Michael Keaton as businessman Ray Kroc and portrays the story of his creation of the McDonald's fast food chain. Nick Offerman and John Carroll Lynch co-star as McDonald's original founders, Richard and Maurice McDonald. In this first scene, Ray Kroc is trying out the kitchen process in his first new franchise location. He shows dedication to uniformity, consistency, and best practice so that he can create a duplicatable process for his intended growth of his franchise idea. But, like any new process, it has its ups and downs. Edward Deming, the father of modern American quality, said that products or services fail due to high variation in sound process. Kroc was dedicated to streamlining uniform process that mitigated wasted time, resources, and energy to meet the goal of high volume, fast service, consistent quality. Let's join Ray now as he observes and leads his production team at his first site in Des Plaines, Illinois.
What are you doing? Come on. It's time to lean. It's time to clean. Let's go.
Put that hat on straight.
400 degrees, right?
Oh, boy. Wait.
Nice. Hey. There's one pickle in there. Two pickles on all the buns. Two pickles on all of them. Don't. Put, look, watch. Pick them like that. Really turn them over and then press them one time. And that was too pink. There, all right? Pretty damn good. What's your name?
Fred Turner, sir.
Nice work.
Fred Turner.
Ray Kroc realized early that his franchise idea could only succeed with enthusiastic, hardworking people to invest in and operate each McDonald's location. His early ventures with investors and owners were dumpster fires, as these independent owners showed a little too much independence by adding items to the menu and extra services that appealed to them but slowed down their ability to deliver products to their customers. And these independent owners veered off from Kroc's idea of consistent process, bringing consistent quality and consistent outcomes. For Kroc to duplicate a sound, effective process in his other franchise locations, owners needed to have a process mindset and a dedication to precision, especially for a manufacturing and service business. He shifted gears to embrace small business-minded entrepreneurs, generally husband and wife teams, that were hungry for making a good living and were coachable to be dedicated to a uniform process that was teachable and manageable. Let's view Kroc's next franchise operation with this new mindset of a dedicated owner-operator model.
As you no doubt know, June, envy is one of the seven deadly sins. And that is just what your friends and neighbors will be guilty of when they see this leather-bound beauty on your bookshelf.
Sir, this is a private place of business. I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Thank you for your time.
Prince Castle Sales.
Oh, hold on. Ray, it's Mac. Do you want to take this?
Yeah, tell him I'll call him back.
Hey, wait a minute. What's your name?
Leonard Rosenblatt.
Rosenblatt? Really? What's a Jew doing selling Catholic Bibles?
Making a living.
I believe in you.
Thank you.
stuck that pickle in. These are ready to spend. Smooth. 275. No salt for 30 seconds, okay? Looking good, fellas. Looking good. Big smiles. You got time to lean, you got time to clean.
It's normally 10 and under, but for you, I'll make an exception.
Love it.
Nice.
My new franchisees are great.
He's in the back working in the kitchen. She's out front handing suckers out to the little kids.
Husband and wife, side by side.
There's so much to take away from this example. The commitment of American business to uniform control process began with the Ford assembly line days and ignited the Industrial Revolution. The same principles apply today in mass production and high volume service. Reduction in variation was the centerpiece of the total quality movement in the 80s and the Six Sigma discipline in the 90s. The definition of quality, according to Deming, is to meet or exceed your customers' expectations. Success of your venture depends on first knowing your customers' expectations, then creating a process that delivers consistency to those expectations. Innovate the process for efficiency. Find frontline managers that are disciplined to the integrity of the process and can coach frontline performers to engage the process. And finally, inspect what you expect. We hope you enjoyed this episode of What Hollywood Teaches Us About. We look forward to presenting our next episode for your education and enjoyment. And if you have any suggestions for movie clips and their messages, please pass them along to me. I'll be sure to give you credit in their production. This is Charles Fellingham saying thanks again for watching and learning. And we'll see you next time.